Welcome. Welcome to the first practice of the fifth series. This series, we're going to start with a yin practice that you could chain with your yang practice. The yin practice, it's good to do it with a body that it's not warmed up. So let's go for it. Let's just go straight to Shalasana. Bring the hips on top of the knees and then slide your hands. Soften your shoulders. We're going to stay here for 4 minutes. And then forehead on the ground. And allow for the body to soften. This is a posture that if you feel there is a lot of discomfort in your lower back, you could always tuck the tailbone in, engaging the pelvic floor and the lower abdomen a little bit, and allowing for the movement to happen more in the middle back, upper back, and shoulders. So it's up to you. Choose whatever it's good for you today. And go to silence, keeping the mind present. Feel the changes. In this posture, some of you might need to be on your chin, depending on how flexible you are. On your shoulders, on your chest. Slowly, good. Just give yourself a couple breaths in Vajrasana with a long spine, feeling the sensations left. This practice is all about keeping a tight presence within. And then you can apply this into your yang practice when there is more movement. Okay, let's go for the second posture. So here we're gonna go to the Sphinx. We have been practicing this posture in our other practices. So the elbows go under the shoulders, flat hands on the ground. You could also do another grip with your hands. I really like my hands flat on the ground here. And even though usually I suggest this posture to be done with a soft pelvic floor and soft lower back, soft glutes, here, because we're going to stay here for longer, it's good to engage the pelvic floor a little bit and the glutes a little bit also to protect the lower back. Roll the shoulders back, send the chest forward, track the arms backwards, and then send the head up so the ears move away from your shoulders. And now find your breath and stay here. Breathe a smile in your lips to soften your attitude. We don't want the attitude to bring rigidness in the body. We want to remain open. So dear friend Kira Sloan. She's an amazing yoga teacher and meditation teacher. When she's teaching yin, she always says, wait for yin. And that's exactly it. Beautiful. Slowly down, one hand on top of the other, the chin on top of both of them, and just a couple of three breaths here. Feel the release. Good. For this next one, we're going to bring the arm in an angle and then lay down in fetal position towards the other side. So adjust the angle depending on how flexible you are in your shoulder. You don't want pain. Remember, pain is not interesting in our practice, never ever. Discomfort is, but pain is not. So since my shoulders are tight, I'm gonna choose a not so wide angle in my shoulder joint. Good. And then here, you can either keep the hand on the ground or even pushing with this hand, sending more weight towards the shoulder, the right shoulder in this case, or you can bring the hand at the back. Whatever feels better for you today in this posture. And then we're gonna stay here for 2 minutes and a half. So soften and relax. Stay present. Stay within.
other side. Remember, adjust the angle depending on how is your shoulder feeling. And since both sides are not the same, both shoulders are not the same, what you needed before, it doesn't have to be what you need now. So this shoulder for me is tighter, so I'm gonna close the angle a little bit more. Okay. And I'm gonna keep the hand here in support of my body, and I'm gonna allow for the body to be quite close, yeah. If I want more intensity, I would push and open the chest more, but that's not what I want today, because my shoulder feels really tight. And if I push more to open the chest up, I start feeling pain. And remember, pain, it's not what we want. Discomfort is a place to grow, a place to expand. Pain is not. And that aligns us with one of the principles of the yoga practice, which is ahimsa. Ahimsa. Without violence. Or without violating what is true today, in this case for my shoulder. Can link also to another of the principles of the practice, satya, being truthful, and santosha, acceptance.
Of the first posture, Chelasana, but that would be more like the prayer posture, and we're gonna use our props, so yeah, something that has that shape more or less, if you don't have blocks, or just piles of blankets, you know, two piles of blankets. You need to be able for your, the head needs to be able to fall down in between them. And then placing the elbows. Placing the elbows on top of the bricks, the hands together in a prayer posture, and then sliding the knees farther down. More or less, you want to keep the pelvis on top of the knees, but it can go a little bit farther down. And then bending the arms, hands towards the back, and allowing for the chest to sink. Okay, here it's important to observe what is going on with the lower back. If the lower back is unhappy, roll the pelvis, tag the tailbone in, engage the pelvic floor, so the movement happens more from the middle back up. And then simply stay here. Soft breath. Keep your attitude of openness. Be ready to feel everything. You don't want to miss out on anything. Remain present, and then you go into silence. You are a listener here, not a talker. you go, and now we are ready for the next one. Okay, we've been doing this in our last series. We have been practicing this posture where the hands move in diagonal from the shoulders out, and then this. That would be option one. Option two, you use this opportunity to work on opening the front of your thigh, the quads. So you go with one hand and with the other you grab the foot. Remember, you want your lower back to be happy, so you might engage your pelvic floor and your glutes a little bit, and then stay here. If this is too much on your left shoulder, you could bring the forearm down to the ground. I'm gonna choose this one now because my shoulders feel kind of tight. And I don't want to overdo it. Yeah? Not overdoing it, it's a really important part of the practice. Because remember, you are not here to push. And the body has its own timing. So, honor the truth of the body. That feels already enough for me today. Good, let's change sides. So remember, you could just bring a straight arm and then grab the foot. Or if that feels like a lot for the shoulder, just bring the forearm down. Engage the pelvic floor, protecting the lower back. And then your soft breath. Softens the attitude. Beautiful. Let go. One hand on top of the other and the chin on top of both. To go, actually three if we count Shavasana. So here you can either, if you don't have blocks, roll a blanket that where you will lay your spine on, yeah, and then have a nice pillow or other blanket for your head. But if you have the blocks, you can play with the blocks flat, or you can play with the blocks in this higher rise. Something like this would also work for the spine. What it's important is that whatever it is, it goes on your shoulder blades, yeah? The block needs to be on the shoulder blades. It cannot be farther down because it's then a little bit too much. If it's a blanket, it will be probably the whole spine. So turn around. This is a supported fish, yeah? Make sure that the block is in between the shoulder blades. Good, and then the head is resting on the block. Good. Where do I have my watch? Sorry, I need my watch. To count time for you, so you don't have to do it.
choose to stretch the legs. You could bend them. You could choose to spread the knees out. So you're already, you're also working on spreading your hips. This is a really nice option. And then it could happen that here you feel discomfort in your lower back. The only thing you need to do is lift the pelvis, roll it, tag the tailbone in, and then bring it back to the ground. And then relax here. We're gonna stay here for 3 minutes. Props. Go down to the ground. Feel how flat your back is on the ground, how much space you have in between the shoulder blades. And then draw a nice angle with your arms. If your hands are not touching, you want to open the angle in your elbows because you want the hands on the ground. And then from here, we're going to do a nice spinal twist. So knees to the left, head to the right. And stay. We're gonna stay here for a minute and a half.
this practice. The more you soften, the more you let go, the more it will happen. The more likely it will happen. Okay, let's change sides so the knees go to the right. And the head turns to the left. And then remember these three principles I told you before. Ahimsa, no violence, so you're not trying to make an effort to send the leg farther down. And then there is satya, truth, which I like to think about it like honesty. Being honest with whatever the limitations in the body. And then that requires acceptance, santosha. And just be there, smile, and wait for it. And you will be amazed. Good, and now bring the knees up, and then we're gonna go to the final posture, Shavasana. Even if you want to chain it with your yang practice, you still have to go through this Shavasana. So relax completely, make sure that your lower back is happy, so position the pelvis in a way that the lower back is content. There is no discomfort, not even discomfort in your lower back in this posture. Good. You might need a pillow under your legs, you know, for the pelvis to roll more and the lower back to be happy. And just connect with the breath, allowing for the body to melt down. Getting into a deeper relaxation. If you choose to keep on going, just go through this Shavasana. If you choose to stop here today, after that Shavasana, you could sit for meditation. Whatever you do, keep the presence.
Namo Amitabhaya, Buddhaya, Dhammaya.
for this yang practice, yin practice. And I will see you on the second practice, which will be more yang practice. Namaste. Thank you very much.